Tonight on SUTV News, NDSU students walk a week without shoes.
An in-depth interview with NDSU's President Dean Brashani.
And in sports, depth chart battles continue as spring practice comes to an end.
This is SUTV News, and it starts now.
NDSU, and welcome to SUTV News. I'm Aaron Berner.
And I'm Nicole Johnson. NDSU's administration has decided to change the definition of a full-time student. Starting this upcoming fall, all students will be asked to take a minimum of 15 credits. The State Board of Higher Education conducted a study reviewing the past tuition and fees model. The results of this study gathered widespread support for putting together a new model. But the biggest reason for the credit increase is the administration's desire for students to graduate in 4 years.
The average course load that a student takes here at NDSU is about 14 and a half credits. And based on the current system, that on a 12 credit load, you're probably not going to be able to graduate in 4 years. 5 years if you're lucky.
The minimum credits to receive financial aid will remain 12 credits. We'll show you what President Brashani had to say about the proposal when Aaron sat down with him later in the newscast.
The Blue Key Honor Society presented a surprise recipient with their annual Doctor of Service Award on Tuesday night. Gene Taylor, the Director of Athletics at NDSU, earned this award because of outstanding dedication to NDSU and the Fargo community. The Blue Key Honor Society's Doctor of Service Award was started in 1930 and is one of the most honorable awards a faculty member at NDSU can receive.
He really reaches out not only to athletics but all over the university as well as the community, and I think that's why it makes him a perfect Doctor of Service recipient. So.
I was really caught off guard. Very honored, very humbled, and it's a great award. I'm just really very lucky to be a part.
Gene Taylor helped NDSU rise to Division I conference and has been dedicated to bettering the student athletes.
Adults looking to go back to college or who are going to college for the first time will have an easier time at NDSU. A $50,000 grant from Bernard Osher Foundation was awarded to NDSU to give scholarships to adult learners. 10 $5,000 scholarships will be awarded in the 2012-2013 academic year. The scholarship program coincides with NDSU's initiative called Non-Traditional No More.
Many students have been shocked by the large amounts of bare feet on campus. But standing away from the herd, a select few were excited about it. The men of Delta Tau Delta are taking off their shoes this week for their first annual Barefoot for Bare Feet campaign. From April 16th until April 20th, the fraternity has organized a fundraiser to raise awareness for those around the world who cannot afford shoes. The students, who are working with the organization Samaritan's Feet, aren't asking for much.
The best way is to make a donation or to tell other people about what we're doing. For just a $10 donation, which is just pocket change for most of us, we were able to through the organization we're working with, provide a kid anywhere in the world with a pair of shoes. So even a little donation can go a long way.
The fundraiser is also encouraging the purchase of Tom's shoes. The company will donate a pair of shoes for each pair that is bought. And you know, four of the members of this fraternity are also going to run the Fargo Marathon barefoot.
Yeah, I heard they're going to do it in four legs, so they're going to switch off. There's four of them, and they're going to run it in sections.
That's probably good not to run the entire 26 miles bare feet. We're just not built for that anymore.
Yeah. Well, after this, Aaron sat down with President Brashani to talk about what's ahead for the university.
At the end of the day, to save money because they're taking...
I'm at bus to get to class on time. I don't have to use my car, waste gas, or waste time finding a parking spot.
I'm at bus because their hybrid buses not only help our community and our state, but they're also helping our world.
I'm at bus not only to get around campus, but to get around the Fargo community. The 25 different routes get me anywhere I need to be.
There are many reasons I'm at bus.
come find yours.
Join the herd. Be Matt Bus Strong.
Jimmy John's, America's favorite sandwich. Delivery guys.
Steps up, throws deep. Holloway is there at the five. Not at the two. Touchdown, Pfizer.
SUTV News is being brought to you by Stop and Go. Stop and Go. We're always there.
Welcome back to SUTV News. There is less than a month left of this academic year.
I sat down with President Bershani earlier this week to discuss this past year, right now, and what we can expect next year.
You want to change the standard of credits for a full-time student to 15?
Yes, sir.
What can you tell me about that, and why do you think that should happen?
Well, traditionally in the United States, that has been the standard. Only in North Dakota did somewhere along the lines a 12 credits start being referred to as full-time. Well, 12 credits is the absolute minimum to qualify for federal financial aid. That's where the only place that comes from. And we know for a fact that if a student takes 12 credits a semester, it doesn't take a math major to figure out you won't graduate in 4 years. You probably won't graduate in 5 years. And so what we're trying to do is recalibrate students' expectations of what a full load is, and at the same time blend in some features to encourage their stronger retention and graduation in 4 years.
The students that I did speak to about this, their biggest concern is when I first voiced it to them, they weren't very happy about it, but when I explained that it doesn't affect financial aid, they would just be advised differently.
Exactly. It doesn't affect financial aid, it doesn't cost them anymore, it's just simply changing the expectation bar to that a full load is 15 credits. Where it does actually provide a benefit to students is if you take more than 15 credits, they're free. So for the student who takes 16, 17, 18 credits, which is a more normal full load at most universities, those students are taking those classes with no cost.
A few months ago, the half of 1% tuition increase got rejected. So obviously, NDSU may have to trim the budget a little bit. How do you propose in doing that next year?
Well, we asked student government, faculty senate, and staff senate to all give us an outline of principles by which we would make those decisions. And we received some very thoughtful feedback. What it really boils down to is trying to minimize the visible felt impact on the learning environment and on undergraduate students in particular. So we're looking for ways to do that without elimination of jobs that are filled by somebody and in a way that hopefully will be invisible to undergraduate students and only a temporary measure. My anticipation is that with the next fiscal year that we will be in a situation where we'd be able to perhaps recover from those cuts that we'll have to make.
What are the biggest challenges that you see facing NDSU right now?
You know, to tell you the truth, it is our underfunded nature is it. We are being extremely successful, if not becoming and have become the top-ranked university in the state in spite of those challenges. If we took those shackles off, it's hard to imagine the successes and the contributions NDSU would make to North Dakota and the rest of the nation. Very proud of what we're doing right now. The educational environment here for our students is exceptional. Our research productivity is climbing. Athletics is off the charts. Everything's going exceptionally well in spite of a hurdle that for most universities would stall them in their tracks. We're not letting that happen here, but when we get rid of that hurdle, it's pretty exciting what we're going to be able to accomplish.
Just to end it off, sort of a kickoff to the year, what's some advice that you can give to graduating seniors?
Well, the first off is stay in North Dakota. There is no faster job growth, no breadth of job opportunities expanding at a faster rate than in the state of North Dakota. You can go right next door to Minnesota and find people struggling to get employed, whereas in North Dakota, it's pick what you want to do and where you want to work and tomorrow start working. This is an exciting time to be in North Dakota. It's an exciting time to start a family, to start becoming part of the permanent success of North Dakota. And my advice to North Dakotans would be look within.
We would like to thank President Brashani for taking the time to talk to SU TV News.
A showcase of NDSU's musical talent at the Fargo Dome. We'll give you a listen after we show you this week's campus calendar.
College is the time to explore career opportunities and cultivate networking skills. Online social networking websites, such as LinkedIn, make this easier than ever. With LinkedIn, you can network with other professionals, search and apply for jobs, and strategically market yourself to potential employers. So let's talk tech. As a specific type of social networking, LinkedIn is dedicated to connecting professionals from a variety of career fields. No matter your major, LinkedIn is a fantastic tool that college students can use to jumpstart their professional careers. To sign up with LinkedIn, all you need is your name and an email address. From there, you can choose from several options to create a personal profile showcasing your previous work experience and education. LinkedIn also gives you the ability to upload your resume for potential employers to view. You can also use critical information from your resume to fill out the key elements of your LinkedIn profile. Next, you can begin building a network of people you know or would like to connect with. These can include coworkers, supervisors, classmates, and potential employers. Find these contacts by searching for their name and or email address and click the Add to My Network link on their profile page. For the soon-to-be graduates interested in finding a job, LinkedIn also offers a job search function that connects you with your dream employers. Some job postings will even give you the opportunity to apply directly through LinkedIn. The LinkedIn job search is also a great tool current students can use to explore the job market and research employer expectations. With over 100 million users, LinkedIn is the world's largest online professional network. So create a free account today and jumpstart your career.
Fargo Dome for a musical battle.
NDSU's campus attractions held Battle of the Bands on Saturday. 8 bands came to compete. Each band performed for 25 minutes on stage. The Fargo Dome was packed with NDSU students cheering and dancing to support their friends. The winning band will open for Band Day at NDSU on April 27th at the Memorial Union.
Competition. We know some of the people in a few of the bands, and we've heard them play, and we played shows with them before, and they're really good friends with us. And so playing with your friends is a lot of fun, but also since it's a competition, we're rooting for the win.
Fox Game Redemption took first place at the battle, and Running on Empty came in second place.
Construction has begun on the new Bison Monument to be placed in front of South Engineering on Albrecht Boulevard. The NDSU Student Senate approved a $25,000 bill to fund the base. The monument itself was donated by an NDSU alumnus. SUTV's Ryan Nelson got an inside look at the sights and sounds of the construction process.
Yep, a flush.
Now I'll just throw a couple nails in these. Being a construction worker is kind of like having Tourette's without the twitching.
Student government hopes to have the statue in place by the end of the school year. The statue will be protected by a polymer developed by NDSU students.
NDSU has proposed the idea of making 15 credits the standard for a full-time student. This week's Cybox Stampede set out to see how students' feelings add up to this change in numbers.
I feel like it could be a good thing, and I don't see it as being a bad thing at all, but definitely a good thing. It would get kids out of here faster, because some people like me like to just take 12 credits and then you're going to be here a long time.
I think that a 12 credit minimum for full time should be sufficient so that if students do want to go full time at school and work, that they have that opportunity.
I think about the minimum for a 15 credit for a full-time student is a good idea.
I just think it's kind of silly to raise it to 15 credits because as a education major, I know like my senior year when I student teach, I'll probably only be taking 12 credits. And so if I can't get the right financial aid, I'm going to be kind of worried about it since financial aid is how I'm paying for school for the most part.
Well, you know, this isn't something that's unique to NDSU. Most other schools actually have this. It's something that worked very well for Brashani at Texas A&M, where it came from.
Yeah, you know, it's important for students to realize that it won't affect their financial aid.
I see no downsides to this. I mean, it won't affect financial aid. And I'm no math major, but 8 semesters at 12 credits a semester will not get you to that 122 that you need to graduate.
At least not quickly.
Spring practice is coming to an end. We will have this and more when we return with SUTV Sports.
With MapBus being the easiest, greenest, and most efficient way to get around North Dakota State University, there are tons of reasons to MapBus.
I MapBus to get to class on time. I don't have to use my car, waste gas, or waste time finding a parking spot.
I MapBus because their hybrid buses not only help our community and our state, but they're also helping our world.
I MapBus not only to get around campus, but to get around the Fargo community. The 25 different routes get me anywhere I need to be.
There are many reasons to MapBus. Come find yours.
Join the herd. Be MapBus strong.
There's always something happening on the NDSU campus. Catch it all on SUTV News on Cable 1, Channel 14. Brought to you in part by Shields and Stop and Go.
SUTV Sports is being brought to you by Shields. Ready for your next big adventure? Welcome to Shields.
Welcome back. Spring practice is coming to an end for the Bison football team. Many position battles are still up in the air, including that for wide receiver. Players like Cooper Wallow Jr. are trying to make some noise and earn themselves a spot on the depth chart. In 15 games last season, Wallow only had 3 receptions for 24 yards, but did play an important role in special teams, including a blocked punt returned for a touchdown against St. Francis. In total last season, the Bison had 16 players catch at least one pass, being forced to play a lot of different players due to injury. The passing game entering the summer looks to be in the same scenario, with a lot of players looking for minutes.
We got a lot of guys fighting for a position, like you said, and they're going to keep fighting. And we're going to have a lot of depth at receiver this year, and God willing, hopefully we can stay healthy at that position, because last year we were pretty banged up.
As long as everyone can contribute, it makes the defense not keying on one person, but play a balanced type of defense, will give everyone a chance to make some plays and get out there.
Spring practice concludes on Saturday with the annual Green versus Gold game. Several players have sat out all of spring practice, still recovering from off-season surgeries. The Bison lost 17 total players from last year's NCAA FCS National Championship team. Although they are excited to have reached the end of spring practice, there is still a lot of work to be done in all aspects.
I think we've got a couple holes to fill in that offensive line, and we're concerned about that. I think anytime you lose two seasoned vets like we did to such a critical unit, that's important.
The Bison open regular season play on September 1st in the Fargo Dome against Robert Morris. Also, it has been announced that their game October 20th against new conference opponent South Dakota will be played on newly remodeled Howard Wood Field in Sioux Falls and not in Vermilion as originally scheduled. Well, to baseball now, and Bison coach Todd Brown became only the third baseball coach in school history to reach 100 wins. He reached that milestone in a 6-1 win over South Dakota State on Tuesday. The border battle continues this weekend. Bison center fielder Tim Colwell tied 2 records last weekend against Western Illinois. He went 5-for-5 to tie the NDSU single game record and also hit his 9th triple, which is a Summit League record. Colwell and the Bison are 25-9 this season, including their 16-game win streak earlier this year. To softball now, and the Bison softball team traveled down to Minnesota to take on the Gophers. Minnesota swept the doubleheader 4-0 and 5-0. In game 2, freshman pitcher Krista Menke allowed only 4 hits and struck out 5 against her first Big Ten opponent. The Bison will be home this weekend to take on Summit League opponent UMKC starting at noon on Saturday. SUTV Sports will televise both games of the doubleheader. And finally, to golf, Amy Anderson shot a 3-over-75 in the final round of the Cretan Golf Classic. She wins this tournament for the 3rd straight year. Anderson battled back after trailing by 2 shots in the first round. It's her 4th victory of the season. Anderson and the Bison will travel to Prim, Nevada on Monday and Tuesday to compete in the Summit League tournament. Well, it's going to be a busy weekend out there for Bison sports fans. Football, baseball, and softball are all going to be in action.
Yeah, all 3 games start around noon or 1, so everyone's going to have something to watch.
And I really hope the weather will be good. I mean, I think it's supposed to get up in the upper 50s by this weekend, so.
Sounds like it should be great weather to get out there at 9 a.m. and start tailgating for the first time this year.
That's right. All right, NDSU architecture students got creative with the recycling. You'll see some of their projects right after this.
Up, throws deep. Holloway is there at the 5. Not at the 2. Good start. Bison.
Jimmy John's? Jimmy John's, America's favorite sandwich delivery guys.
There's always something happening on the NDSU campus. Catch it all on SU TV News on Cable 1, Channel 14. Brought to you in part by Shields and Stop and Go.
SU TV News is a production of the Bison Information Network in conjunction with the North Dakota State University Department of Communication.
This week at the Memorial Union Art Gallery's NDSU's Architecture Department put on an exhibit titled EcoArt. The exhibit, which focused on sustainability, features students' finished projects from an architecture seminar class. Students used old materials and repurposed their parts to make something new and useful. The projects ranged from a bed frame crafted into a bookcase, a bicycle made into a chair, and even an old washing machine drum made into portable iPod
and going
speakers.
Green and being sustainable is gaining momentum. And at NDSU, we're kind of at the brink of starting some sustainability planning. And the architecture department is probably one of the more innovative departments in tackling that topic. And important for students, it's a great example for them to be able to see things repurposed. So they may look at items in their apartments, in their dorm rooms, in a little bit different light.
Well, the point of the project was to make something that was recycled into something beautiful and useful.
Well, I know that one of the students at least used old computer parts to make toys for little kids. All right, well, Jake, I know back to our busy Saturday, the spring training's finishing up for football. How does the lineup look for next year?
They're looking to be strong. We'll see on Saturday how they're doing, but they're returning a lot of key players from last year, and fans all around can actually watch the game on KVLY. They'll be broadcasting the game this year with a pregame starting at 12:30 and then the ring ceremony and kickoff coming a little bit after 1.
We'll be sure to watch it. All right, well, thank you for watching SU TV News. Be sure to pick up your copy of The Spectrum. We go out tonight with a bang as we leave you with some sights and sounds of the NDSU Marksmanship Club.
You gotta get an H, exclamation points, and a 2.
Yep.
We're just a fundraising effort to try to help support the program.
They hit it, it's supposed to explode. So then they get so many points for each Bob Pop.
You get the card, you move on to the next card, or the next card.
Well, the card that's sideways.
Shoot, 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 shoot. Make the line safe, score.
Okay. Left side will go towards you, so the flat side comes in like that.
That's not as tight as it should be.
You know, I mean, the gun is zero.